locked door has red text on it reading, "All are awaited, all are embraced. None shall escape." Familiar, but you can't quite recall where you heard it.
Present me well from gifts thine own, or I shall rend thy flesh from bone. A grasping hand, an offering vile. Enter now the dread lord's trial.
Upon murder's progeny, child.
His most ill-trusted zealots.
His faithful departed.
Prodigal servants, each returns to do his bidding eternally.
This man is known to all Baldurians, and his presence sparks dread in the pit of your stomach. Before you is Saravok Anchev, a Baalist who almost brought Baldur's Gate to ruin a century ago.
This is the court of the Dread Lord's Tribunal. I am its custodian. Here come those who seek to transcend. Aspirants of his most profane order. The would-be unholy assassins of Baal. A long while ago, my wretched sibling bought me back. The fairest of Baalspawn soul-bound me to this husk. Worship death though I do, I refused it. I roamed the coast, gathering those who still held Baal in their black hearts. The cult survived, festering beneath the city, with me as the gate's everlasting poison. But no more, for poison is too slow a death. Now is the time for slaughter. With these killings, the glory of the Baalis has risen beyond what we dreamed possible during those dark days. But the worship of my lord is led by another now. My granddaughter, Arin, the youngest unholy assassin ever to follow in Baal's bloody trail. And his chosen. She is the architect of Baal's design. Baal has never had a more gifted prodigy. Auryn's gifts surpassed even her mother's. Her mother knew this, and she could not bear it. When Auryn was but 7 years old, she tried to smother the child as an offering to our Lord. I heard the screams. I ran to help. I feared for the child's life. But the cries were not Auryn's. It was her mother's blood that soaked the sheets. Auryn had cut off the very hand that tried to end her and made a plaything of it. And as she toyed with her dead mother's hand, a deep quiver rose up through her throat. The Lord of Murder speaking through the child. Lay not a finger on this child, he said, nor let any other, for this child will serve me with unholy ardor. Protect her in my name. I knew of my daughter's ambitions, but not the lengths to which she'd go. She hungered for Baal's favor more than anyone I'd ever known. But her daughter, Auryn, hungered even more. My lord made his choice. I abided by his words. But Auryn is not the subject of our judgment here today. You wish to become an unholy assassin of Baal. So, approach and be judged. There is no better mirror in which to see the true nature of a killer than his victim. You took their hands from them. Now, I will clutch one of their souls from the abyss, that they may show Baal who you are. Let us begin. Spirit of the slaughtered, return to us. Show us the truth of this murderer's intent, and let us judge him for his bloody service.
His will be done.
You took this spirit's life, and thus its voice. So, speak for it. How was this pitiable creature slain? An unholy assassin of Baal has victims, not adversaries. A victim does not know honor. A victim knows terror and pain.
You have been judged.
You have been found wanting.
Unworthy.
You will make a most beautiful offering to the Lord of Murder.
I've got it.
resting place.
By my hand.
should I do? Onward.
Concentrate.
I'd love to, thanks.
All's well that ends, yeah, not as bad as it could have.
Oi! Citizen! Get me out of here! Citizen! Thank the gods you're here!
My wrinkles are starting to chafe. As an officer of the law, I demand you free me at once.
I wonder what's past this.
Here and free me at once!
Thanks for freeing me so quickly. No idea what those barlist Burks had planned with me, but those chains were starting to chafe.
Though I do wish you'd figured this all out before I... put the blame for Father Lorgan's murder on that poor refugee. Well, at least it's over now.
After our chat at Charette's Caress, I thought it best to polish off the bottle I'd started. I started coming over all woozy. My joints stiffened up quicker than a brothel browser's loins. Paralyzed. My vision went black. When I woke up, I was in chains.
Overall, a terrible ordeal.
One deserving of a drink. I bid you good day, but it's been royally shite all round.
You might not be finished.
I am. It's plain to see that I'm well out of my depth here. But you... well, you gave these reprobates a proper seeing to. You clearly have what I don't. Courage, insight, heroism. The city needs you. I overheard these pigs talking. There's a Baal temple deep within the old Undercity that the cult is using. A century ago, it was destroyed by a group of heroic sorts. Let's hope history repeats itself, eh? This place is foul as piss. I'm out of here.
it's fine. Whoever else appears, they will be bested. They will triumph.
Blood follows me everywhere. Phrase, Sicarius, and a location. We should find this Kendall Hallow place.
Await your good. Ah, you finally come. Have you retrieved the Orphic hammer? Will our prince's chains finally be broken? The Prince of the Comet is not dead. The Prince of the Comet will come again. The Prince of the Comet will liberate us from the Lich Queen's tyranny. The prophecy is one step closer to fruition. Among the Githyanki, one gift is esteemed above all others. The Silver Sword. Take it. Wield it in honor of Gith, the great liberator, and her unforgotten son. Iztik, now that you have the hammer, you must find a way to enter the astral prism. Once inside, smash Orpheus's bonds. His cry will shake the plains, and I will fly to your aid. The Prince of the Comet will sear the heavens again. First we'll defeat the Absolute, then we let the Lich Queen tremble.
Think again. I will not permit your entry.
Questions, Iztik? You seem to be lost in thought. Yes, but you will meet this challenge, as you've met so many others. The Prince of the Comet aches for Githyanki liberation more than he abhors Geich. He might seethe when you free him. He might gnash his teeth and slander your name, but he will see reason. I promise you. Iztik, friend to Orpheus. Together we will end the Elder Brain which shakes this city. Then I turn my sights to Vlakith, the Queen of Deceit. When you break Prince Orpheus free, his psionic cry will alert us. I will fly to your side.
This house doesn't work. Sometimes the only way out is through. Cut into the chase.
To let up. Got to move.
A dull moment.
Yeah.
My faith will protect me. On the move.
Breathing, despite everything. Still on my feet.
What should I do? Just a brief respite. Need to keep sharp.
Romantic ritual, perhaps.